Hello everyone, today we are going to learn a brand new topic, Interface Python with SQL, or in simple words, how to link Python with MySQL. Our aim will be to store data or the records in SQL, whereas the Python is going to execute the SQL query. I repeat, Python is going to execute SQL query. Wow, it seems interesting, isn't it? Okay, so let's proceed. To connect or to link Python and SQL, we have to follow five basic simple steps. But we'll be covering it one by one in the coming slides. So beginning from the first step, what is it? Import mysql.connector. Okay. To import mysql.connector, first of all, make sure that this module is installed in your Python directory. If you don't have, no worries. You can install it to your Python directory by using the command pip install mysql connector. So always make sure you reach the Python directory as given over here. Reach the scripts folder and then give the command pip install mysql minus connector. That's it. Okay. Now come back. This module mysql.connector. The purpose of this module is to communicate with the MySQL server. Okay, it has well-defined functions to establish data connectivity and to do data manipulations. So now look at the diagram. I have the database system 1, and inside the disk database we are having a table items. Now the purpose of this entire session is going to take all the records from the table items and bring it to Python. Cool, isn't it? Okay. So step 1 is clear, it's simply importing the module, import mysql.connector. Now step number 2. Step number 2 is to establish the connection with the database. Okay. So when we are working with SQL, there might be n number of databases. So this might be system 10, 11, system 12 and system 3 and so on. So please recollect, I need to collect the data from my database, which is system 1. Okay. And from this, I have to extract the records from the table items. So to connect with exactly to this database, I'll be using the function connect, which belongs to mysql.connector module. So how do we do that? mysql.connector.connect, and then provide relevant details like host, user, password, and the database. Now host is taken as localhost because my database is locally available. In the case of user, I don't have any username when I'm logging into MySQL, so I have provided it as root. Password is taken as tiger because my password to login with SQL is tiger. Now considering the database, of course my database is system 1. So by executing this much, I have actually established the connection to particular database, that is system 1. Okay. Now step number 3. Once you have the connection established with the database, it's time to fetch the records from the table items. For that, we require a tool, and that is the cursor object. Now, this object is used to execute the statements to communicate with the database. Okay, so the cursor object is going to execute the statements. And how do we create a cursor object? By using the function cursor. Okay, the cursor object is created by the connection object. So make sure this connection object is used to create a cursor object. So in this entire code, I created two objects. One is the connection object, which connects to the database. Second one is going to be the cursor object, C-U-R, which is going to help you with the execution of SQL statements. Fine? Okay. Now let's proceed. Now, since the cursor object is now ready, it's time to execute the query. So, and how do we do that? Cursor.execute. So, you are going to use the function execute and just give the respective query whichever you want to execute. So, in my case, I want to extract all the records from the table items. So, I have provided the query select star from items. So, if I execute this much of code, what is going to happen? All the records from the table items is extracted and brought to the cursor object. Okay, technically we call this set of record as record set. Fine. So the cursor object is now ready and the table has been retrieved into the cursor object. Now it's time for printing it. For that, just iterate through the record set or the cursor object by using a for loop. So you can see over here I have written for I in cursor and then print each and every I. So the cursor object has all the records, so each and every record is going to be printed, and let's see what's going to happen if I execute this. Wow, look over here, all the records from the table items is extracted. Cool. So that was the end of this session. After retrieving all the records, you might be feeling excited, you might be feeling very happy to continue with the lab session. Of course we have to, but finally before we end up, let's recap all those five basic simple steps once again. Number one, exactly, import the mysql.connector. Number two, once you have imported, go and take your database or link to the database by using the connect function. Okay, so once you have connected with the database, it's time to extract the record. And to extract the record, we need to execute a query, and to execute the query, we need a cursor object. So prepare the cursor object, and the cursor object executes the query by using the function execute. And once your query is executed, of course your result is ready to get printed, and you can print it by using simple for loop. Okay, so that was the end of this session. Follow the next video for the lab session. Happy coding. Thank you.